So now we capture the image, the camera. So we have got a file. So how is the file stored? So again, so we have to realize this, because once we store it in a very bad fashion, so further analysis will become a problem. So that's why this was a very important specification when we implement a machine vision system. So file formats and compression. So what are the different file formats? Because you are aware now. So when I started teaching the subject some 10 years back, even internet was just coming up. So we didn't have mobile phones these days. So file formats are an orderly sequences of data used to encode digital information for storage or exchange. So in order to store the data, we have to keep it in some ordered fashion. So that is the file format. Or if you want to exchange with somebody else, not only somebody else, sometimes we may have to transfer from one software to another, then also the file format becomes important. So for example, surface finish measurement, Alicona instrument will give AR3D format as output. Whereas the Taylor Hobson instrument will give SWFS, some other format. So each company has a proprietary format. And then for exchange, they are giving some common format. So that is okay. That is now the theme of Industry 4 and all. So how to transfer data. So when you are using different software, you should be able to transfer from one to other easily. So that's why exchange file formats are very important. So the file format starts with an introductory header section followed by a body. So the header will describe what is the type of file, how the data is arranged, etc. Any dictionaries are used. So what are the common file formats? So the tagged image file format is the TIFF format. Now that is not much seen in the internet and all, because this is not so, generally it has a bigger size, which is not very common. But the advantage is that it is a lossless format. Then we have PNG, Portable Network Graphics. Then JPEG, Joint Photographic Experts Group, or JFF, then GIF, Graphic Interchange Format. So these are the common formats earlier. And of course, BMP is there, but it is not commonly used because it is very much space consuming. So compression. So file, the raw data is very big. So actually some cameras give the option to capture the data in raw format and then you can convert it to any other files using your software. So the raw format will give a lot of additional information. Whereas once you convert to another format, some data is lost. So if possible, it is better to start capturing it in the raw format. And then that of course depends on the hardware. So the camera manufacturer will give some filter to convert it to any standard format. So especially Photoshop. Photoshop is very commonly used to edit the image and all. So most manufacturers will give the corresponding converter to convert it to Photoshop format. Okay, so compression. So storing this raw file format will be very, it consumes a lot of space. So we don't prefer to store it in that way. So we have to compress it. So a way of encoding a file's data more concisely or efficiently is called compression. So there are two conflicting requirements in compression. So we should reduce the file size as much as possible. But at the same time, we should open it very fast also. So we can reduce the file size very much by, for example, I don't know, if you have downloaded some software from open source software, for example, GIMP, which is open source equivalent of Photoshop. So that is, it is available as a tar bot, tar.gz. So first they convert into a tar file, TAR file, and then it is converted into .gz. So file size is reduced very much. But to open it is difficult. It takes some time. So first you have to convert, remove the .gz, then you have to remove the .tar. Then you get all the integer files. So we have to balance these two conflicting requirements. So if you store without any compression, opening is very easy, but file size taken will be large. If you store with large amount of compression, file size will be very small, but opening it will be difficult. So we have to balance that. So what are the methods of compression? So generally we can see that there are two strategies adopted: redundancy and irrelevancy. So redundancy reduction. So redundant information, we don't have to throw away. So all of you know, when you are writing a table and the same name comes below, we don't have to write the name every time below. Just say do or ditto. So same way. So this is used when the image is being encoded or re-encoded. We look for patterns in the data. So original raw data will be having some patterns. So say there are several white bits or several bits in the same intensity. So you can, instead of saying that each bit, this is the intensity, you say this bit is 5 and next 50 bits are also 5, like that. So we look for patterns and repetitions, which we can express in a simpler fashion. For example, if there are 25 black pixels in a row, it is clearly better to record the information for one pixel and state that the next 24 are all the same than to record each pixel separately. So next 24 ditto, that is a short form to reduce file size. So this strategy is called redundancy reduction. The other strategy is irrelevancy reduction. So irrelevancy reduction removes or alters information that makes little or no difference to the perception of the image. So, for example, so that is the advantage of the MP3 file. So, what do we do in MP3 file? So, our limitation of the ear. So we can hear only from, say, 5 hertz to 50 kilohertz or something. So all data in the music, which is below these two, below that limit or above the upper limit, can be thrown away. And we will not hear any difference. But maybe if you give it to a dog or a cat, it may be able to identify the difference, because air frequencies are, sensitivities are different. So irrelevancy reduction is based on this. So what is not required? But maybe for machine vision applications, sometimes we can make use of that data. So that is why that capturing format is important. So if you convert into some of the lossy formats, some of the data is lost, and those methods of analysis cannot be applied. So that is why this is important when you are implementing machine vision. So lossless compression. So compression where no data is lost. So they are based on redundancy reduction and typically concentrate on more efficient ways of encoding the image data. So they don't throw away any data. Then we say it's a lossless compression. No information is retrievably lost in the process. So just like when you convert a file to a zip file, you store several files in a zip file, then no information is lost. So you can always get back the entire, all the files as original. So that is a lossless compression. So one of the famous algorithms, one of the first algorithms for LZW compression by Lemmel, Zill and Welch. So historically that's what was very popular because they are the pioneers in this method. So they look for recurrent patterns in the image raster data. So raster data is what the matrix, the raw matrix, replacing these with codes, giving the most common patterns, the shortest codes, and storing all the definitions in a separate dictionary. So you make, you find out for patterns. What are the patterns which are repeated patterns? And these repeated patterns, you make a list. That is your dictionary. So first you have to see, okay, dictionary, one letter, okay, one word will have certain number of cells. So together, all this together, we can cover the original data. This is LZW compression. So GIF files use LZW compression. But unfortunately, these people copyrighted this, the algorithm for compression. So CompuServe had that patent and they were filing case, started filing cases against everybody, especially in the 2007 after internet started. So then people started stopping the big companies and all, they don't want to get into legal problems. So they started avoiding this GIF file and they just started adopting PNG file, which is also similar. Lossy conversions. Now we come to conversions where some data is lost. So this is based on redundancy reduction strategies, but will usually also employ some redundancy strategies, particularly in the encoding. So it gives much larger reductions in file size. But it is irreversible. So once you convert into a new file, you will not be able to get back the original file. It permanently disposes of information. So, but file size is reduced with that. So for example, a WAV file, if an audio file, so 1 minute of a WAV file may take 10 MB. But if you convert into MP3, 1 minute will cover only 1 MB. So there is a tenfold reduction in space required when we convert into MP3. So lossy conversions throw away information. So that is a problem with this approach. So the most popular compression is a file format, almost universal in the internet world, is the JPG file format. JPG or JPEG is the full name. If you say JPG only nowadays, have only 3 letters in the file. So earlier DOS had that limitation, only extension could be only 3 letters. So JPG was developed by the Photographic Association Group, Photographic Experts. So because of that, it was deliberately made royalty free because of the complaint with GIF. So GIF had to pay money to the company. So to avoid that, this was made royalty free. So it was made by an association. So it gained wide acceptance It was jointly in collaboration with camera manufacturers and all. So it was made to for photography, ideally for photography. Again, it is photographer's group only. So to store photographs, best method was adopted. So what is the conversion? So the first step, they use a discrete cosine transform to shift the image's color values into a mode that can be more efficiently compressed and coded. So the color values are first converted into frequency data. So how do you do that? So Fourier transform. So using Fourier transform, we convert the analog data to frequency data. So this frequency data, so now we are in MP3 also same thing is used. So frequencies below 5 hertz, you can throw away. Frequency above 50 kilohertz, that can be thrown away. So first step, you convert into frequency data. Then quantization simplifies and rounds the color values before they are imported. So continuously all the frequencies you don't have to store. So you can resolve only a certain frequency, say 500, then maybe you cannot identify 505, it all looks strange to you. So 500, 550, 600, etc. So in music also, we have only, how many notes are there in music? I think 12 notes or so. So, because even though we can think of, mathematically we can think of infinity notes, but we can't really distinguish much. So, 12 notes are good enough for most practical purposes. So first step is the conversion into frequency data and then quantization. So, you limit to certain levels, convert into say 12 nodes or so. I don't know exactly. Same way, images also. We have, eye also cannot distinguish all the color differences. So the limit, there is a limit to our eye. So that alone need to be stored. So for images that are being viewed, that is enough. But for images that can be used for machine vision applications, we can. The computer can distinguish between the intensities and can go for higher resolutions if possible. So the same limitation need not. So that's why we don't have to start capturing in JPG. If you can capture in a lossless format, that is always better. That's why I'm taking this chapter. It's important that decide what camera you buy. So if your camera can capture in better quality format, like lossless TIFF format and all, that can be. That will have more data, which can make use of. So JPG compresses small 8x8 pixel block for the picture at a time. So this, it scans 8x8 pixel blocks at a time, working from top left to bottom right. Because the simplification of each 8x8 pixel block is done independently at a high compression, but it's a low quality, the boundaries between the blocks will begin to show, causing the block thinness. So if you zoom a JPG image and up to 8 pixels, you can see that it will be in block, one block of 8 pixels will be almost very similar. Okay, so that is the, because it is compressing 8 blocks, 8x8 pixel blocks at a time. Okay, so that is the JPG format. Then for improvement, newer approaches have been tried, but nothing has become very popular. I don't know, these all started teaching, they thought people said this is going to become popular. But one reason is maybe the hard disk prices are coming down. So in 2000, I purchased my first computer. That time the hard disk was, I think 100 MB or so. So that was the capacity of the hard disk. So now 1 TB is my hard disk, desktop. So see how much, so the, but the cost is approximately same. That time also Hard disk was around 5,000. Now also, hard disk is around 5,000. Last week I purchased one, so instead of SSD is only 5,000 rupees. So, whereas the mechanical hard disks are 5,000, even cheaper. So, SSD 500 GB is only 5,000 rupees. Whereas other one, 2 TB is only 5,000. So, anyway, I didn't have much data to store, so fast. Okay, so newer approaches. Fractal compression is one technique, wavelet compression is another technique. Those days, people used to say in future this is going to be the solution, but no, it has not materialized. Even now, we are still following JPG. So, fractal compression. So, approaches the image as a picture rather than a series of numbers to be processed. So, JPG and all looks at just numbers. For a fractal, you look at a pattern as arrays in the matrix. So, fractal compression looks for recurrent shapes and patterns in the image and replaces these with equations. So, for a line instead, so if you find a line of points, then it can store as that equation of a line, starting point, end point, and it is a line in between. So that is the idea of fractal compression. But so in order to display the image, then this requires more power, more computing power, because you have to convert the data to using equations, you have to get back all the other data, old data. So this was the STL format. So some places and all this is used. Maps and all. So aerial photography, satellite maps, etc. Next is wavelet compression. So the wavelet transform regards the image as a signal or a wave. It organizes the image information to continuous wave and decomposes it by repeated averaging. So you choose a certain width and takes the average over all the widths. And then the width you change and get for various frequencies. So small, very small width. What is the limit which you can see? Up to that only you have to reduce. Beyond that you can skip. So that is the idea of wavelet conversion. So JP2 or JP2000, JPEG 2000, that was in 2000 this was introduced. But I don't know, even now it is Photoshop and all is possible, but mostly nobody uses JP2 file. So our expectation of the future 20 years back does not seem to be valid. So still people are using the same JPG file. So they said that now in future all cameras will be giving the images in JP2 file, but that has not happened. Okay, so with that we complete